In this video, we're going to be breaking down the lighting and texturing of this video so that you can see how you can put together a wine scene like this. So the lighting and the materials are the biggest thing that I notice separates really bad wine renders from ones that look kind of like this. And I'm no wine expert or wine rendering expert or anything like that. I just wanted to show people things that they can apply to make their renders in general look better, but also their wine renders. So quickly put the scene together with the materials and all that stuff. And I thought I'd show you the things that I did to put these things together. So firstly, from a lighting perspective, it's pretty simple. So if I turn off all the lights and start from zero, you'll see what we essentially start off with, which is black. We've just got a little bit of a gradient for our background and some illuminated text. But if we start from our lighting here and we go boom, turn this on, it's pretty simple. Got a main light for the label. We've got a light for the edge over here to define shape. Otherwise, this is just fading into the background and you don't know what the shape of the bottle is like. And then we've got another rim light to define more shape for the bottle as well. And then here, this section here is a little bit dark, so just added in a flat light for an area light inside of Octane to fill in this section over here. And that just adds in a little bit of light. So that's a very basic lighting structure and a very basic rundown. And then for our materials, this is very similar to the live stream I did on the gin bottle, where you've got it in layers. So here's our graphic layer, which is just for our plain graphic and our fabric, and this is mainly the layer for the fabric. Then if we've got a mix material, it mixes our fabric layer, which is this one, and adds on top our red shiny layer here. And then in between that, we've got this mix material. So if we add this mix material on top, this mix material adds on our illuminated texture. So if I turned off all the lighting, you'll see this was without the illuminated text. And we really wanted, you could just do this in Photoshop as well, but a quick way to just make sure like white text like this is always visible is just having an emission texture underneath there, and then bloom, there you go. And then on top of that, we've got our red shiny layer here. So if I turn these lights back on, here you can see our red shiny layer. Without it, it's just like that. And then with this on top, we've got our red shiny layer on top. And then all of those added together, as well as our displacement map. So here, there's no displacement map for our label. So if I get maybe a little bit of a closer look into our label here, take a nice and close look here. That's what it currently looks like. And then if you add on our displacement map, you can see how we get a bit of extrusion going on over here. Also a little thing over there. And then if you look at the shot, this all these things added up together is what gives you a final shot that looks similar to this. So I've gone through all these processes of mixed materials and stuff and a lot of other tutorials and live streams. Just wanted to give you a basic rundown of how this was made, so you can apply this to any wine or bottle renders that you're doing for you. So hopefully you enjoyed this very quick tutorial, and hopefully you learned something and can apply it to your work. Have a good one.